Greetings, my name is Elias Vic, and welcome to this episode here in 3D Studio Max on modifiers. Today we're going to take a look at the effect region modifier found here in the modifiers panel. So what I've done first of all, if I just disable the modifier, is that I made a plane here quite simply, and then added on some length segments and width segments to make it more interesting for the modifier that we're going to use. So if I now turn back on the modifier here, we instantaneously get this nice cool effect here, almost like the model is pinched upwards like that. Now if we go in here and zoom in, we have a straight line going here all the way up into like an arrow kind of thing. What this is doing here now is affecting the region of our model and pinching it upwards to this point here. So what I can do now is to click the plus icon up here and click on points. This will now enable me to select these points that we have in here and affect them. So I can move them up or down until I get the desired effect. If I then also look to the parameters here in the right, I can change the fall off. I can increase it up so we get this effect here. And I can also change the pinch, which will do that. And change the bubble to get this crater-like effect. This modifier here is actually mostly used for animation, in my opinion. I would not really see a great use for this in your work with static models or things like that, because you can use other effects in your editable poly modifier here to get a similar effect. But it's really cool, and let me just show you and demonstrate to you what you can do with this in the animation perspective of it. So if I go to points now and just drag these down a bit more, like that, and decrease the fall off a bit, I can then move the point of this one here forward, almost like it's looking like a shark in the water now. Well, sort of. I can also go ahead and just make the plane a bit more like that, so we get that smaller thing there. I can then go into points again and select both of the points here, and I can then move them backwards and then move them forward here. Now looks like it's a shark just coming through the water or something like that. You can change and play around with these effects here, pinching for example to get another effect. And it's quite of a nice modifier, mostly used for animation as I said, and I would not really see too much more use for it more than that. I hope that you learned something from this video. Have a nice day, and I'll see you as soon as I can.